All right, good day, my friends. Happy Monday to you all out there. And being a Monday, that means it's time for... No, not that. It's time for Model Builders Monday. You know what we got today? We got this guy.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Grandpa Marks Hobbies and a build update of Revell's 68 Dodge Dart Hemi 2-in-1 kit. Our body right now is just painted.
Now, this has been a very difficult week to choose which build kit that I liked, because so many of you out there did some amazing work. Just unbelievable. It's mind-blowing. But I gotta admit, Mark's build did stand out. I really like the dart he's doing right now.
I did do a couple of things on it, but no need to pull it back over. Let's talk about this. We are in titanium gold right now.
Yes, it does help that I love Dodge darts, being a Mopar crazy guy, Mopar nut, whatever you want to call it. But the details on this thing, you guys gotta watch his channel, you gotta subscribe to him, you gotta check out this build. Check out this build. There's also one more thing that Mark has an advantage over the rest of us building model kits, and that he has a crew working on his kits. Yes, that's right. A whole crew of mini Marks have been found wrenching on engines, banging on sheet metal, and painting up some of his kits. So he's way ahead of us in assembling. And of detailing his model kits, he's got some truly amazing work. Like I say, check it out. I'm going to show you this video clip of him doing some of his stuff, and we'll go back to having coffee. Mm-hmm. You know it.
They're looking sweet. They will get a little bit of weathering. We're going to use some of the Weathermaster. I will use the C on this one for the rust.
Mark does a masterful job of showing us how to detail model kits. He does engine detailing, showing how his process goes, all the paints he uses, all the tools he uses. Very nicely done, Mark. Thank you muchly for showing us all that. Even alternators, how he highlights the windings of the alternators. Just superb job there.
I didn't prime it. I didn't do anything like that. It's the Tamiya's titanium gold. But I'm going to show you. This is after 4 days of sitting. No primer, just paint, smooth as glass.
So Mark also took the time out to cut the ashtray out and make a working ashtray. Unfreaking believable. And listen to his voice in his videos. It reminds me of Chevy Chase in the movie Fletch, my favorite movie of all time. I'll put a clip in and you can listen to the sameness in those two voices.
And now there's that. Remember we cut out for the ashtray? Here's the ashtray. I painted it silver. I made the little part that holds the cigarette with the hole in it. And then I made a couple of cigarette butts, put them in there, put one longer cigarette in there, like it's still lit. I didn't paint it red, I just painted ash, like it burned itself out.
I'm gonna need some pliers and a set of 30 weight ball bearings.
What?
Yeah, tell you what, I gotta go to my truck. Fred gets here before I'm back, you can tell him to start without me. Now you prepare that Fetzer valve with some 3-in-1 oil and some gauze pads. And I'm going to need about 10 quarts of antifreeze, preferably Prestone. No. I'll make that Quaker State.
How do you catch him? Shut eye. Just lay back and enjoy. Try to breathe through your nose.
She looks like a hooker. Look at her. Look at her. Could you love someone who looked like that?
What are you talking about? Of course not. 5-10 minutes tops, maybe.
Oh, it's me, Dr. Rosenpenis. I'm just here to check out Danwick's...
Now, how long have you had these pains, Mr. Barber? Drop your shorts and bend over, Mr. Babar.
Oh, no, really, we don't need to. We don't want to do that. Say, you know, my kidneys feel a lot better in this position. Maybe it's just that I'm not doing any calisthenics. You know, if I did some sit-ups in the morning or bent over like this, I'd probably feel 100% better. Moon River. Whew. Thank you, Doc. You ever serve time?
Breathe easy.
Breathe easy. As a matter of fact, you using the whole fist, Doc?
Just relax. Well, I don't find anything wrong with you.
Huh. Well, I'm sure it's not for a lack of looking.
So for whatever reason, Fletch is my favorite comedy of all time. I can watch that movie over and over and over again. And I just think it's a real uncanny voice resemblance with Mark. I highly recommend that you go watch his channel and subscribe to it. That's Grandpa Marks Hobbies YouTube channel. Well worth your time. His current build of the Hemi Dart, which he's actually retrofitting a 440 in, it was my favorite build of the past week. So next week we'll see what else we got in store coming up. So thanks, Mark, for sharing your build with us, sharing your expertise and your knowledge. Really appreciate that. And all you other guys out there who are doing videos and posting on YouTube, sharing your knowledge also. But Mark, I love this dart. Keep going on it. I can't wait to see that finish. So, cheers to you, brother, and cheers to the rest of you. We'll end it here. I'm gonna go back into my own branch and start working on some stuff there. You're an inspiration, Mark, so now I want to go build. I should be taking advantage of summer and going on a holiday, but you know what? We'll pass on that for now. Maybe next week we'll go somewhere back to Tofino and the surfing area of Long Beach there. Who knows? Anyways, blah, blah, blah. I know. Thanks for watching, my friends. Until next time, stay awesome.
Cut the trunk out because I needed a place to put the battery because I am going to light the headlights on this. And there's a real good possibility that the taillights might be lit too. We'll see about the taillights. If I do the taillights, I might even try to do a little bit of fiber optic work on the markers too. But don't hold me to that. Don't even hold me to the taillights right now. It's just a, you know, something I'm thinking about. So let's get this out of the way.